Greetings, cyberdogs and citizens of the interwebs. This is Ren Diggity Dog coming at you on the other side of a nether portal in this Let's Play Minecraft Survival series. And it looks like we are kicking off today's episode with a little bit of a derp here, my friends. I forgot to bring a bed. Oh my goodness, it is the middle of the night. But it looks like there are a bunch of sheep around here that we can slay. We have come out in the middle of a beautiful birch forest. Isn't this gorgeous? It's the middle of the night, though. There are undead everywhere. Get out of the rose bushes, you ugly zombie bastard. Oh my goodness, we are getting flooded over here. Hang on, hang on. Rambo 2, do your business. Take flaming arrow to the brain, zombie bastard. How many bits of wool do we have? We've got 2 bits of wool. Let's find one more. There we go. There's a sheepish little bugger over there. 2 creepers to deal with, though. Hello, creepers. Get out of here. Hello, sheep. Give me some mutton. Give me your skin. Thanks. There we go. That should be enough to make for ourselves a bed. Excellent. Welcome back, everyone, to another episode of Minecraft Survival, man. Here we are, in the middle of freaking nowhere. We set off on an adventure in the previous episode to find for ourselves some new Minecraft 1.10 stuff. Most specifically, or more specifically should I say, we are looking for some Minecraft 1.10 villagers so that we can get some mending books. That's the plan anyway. So here we are on an adventure, probably 1,000 blocks away from our original spawn, something like that. Well, 1,000 blocks in the nether, so 8,000 blocks in the overworld. So we've come pretty far from home, which is fantastic. Get out of here, zombie. This knockback sword though, absolutely annoying. Anyway, let's sleep this night away, man. Get the sun up and let's have a look around our environment. This is very beautiful. This lake, look at this. Oh man, oh, this is so beautiful. I'm so pumped, guys. I woke up super early this morning to start playing some Minecraft with you guys. It's about 7:30 in the morning. I've just finished my breakfast and I couldn't wait to start playing survival, man, because we are on an adventure today. I want to find some cool stuff. Now, there's a number of things that we have not yet found in the survival series. We've never found a mesa, and I'm desperate to find a freaking mesa biome if possible. We've also never found a jungle temple, and there's a jungle over here, so this could be our lucky freaking day. Wow, this is a lot of sheep. Hi, hello sheeps. Did I bring that bed with me? Yes, I did. Actually, I want to drop off all of this netherrack, man. I don't want none of this in my inventory. Get out of here, netherrack, and probably get rid of the flint and steel. All of this junk and get out of my inventory, man. I need to make some space in case we find some sweet stuff. What else have we not found? We found an icy spikes biome. We've done that. We've never found a stronghold, believe it or not. We have never, because we've never been to the end, of course. We have never found, is there anything else we've never found? I think that pretty much does it. So, if on this adventure, we can find a mesa, a desert temple, and some sort of a village with a villager that trades mending books, I will be ridiculously happy. It would be the most epic adventure ever. Well, here we are in a jungle, so let's see if we can tick off the first thing on the wish list over there. There's a freaking chicken in the jungle over there. And yeah, beautiful looking jungle. Absolutely massive. Loving this. What is going on over there? Oh, I think that's a is that a savanna biome? It looks like it. That looks pretty cool, man. Let's go a little bit deeper into this jungle, though. You never know what we might find. We've never found a village in a jungle, either. I know that there have been some instances of that happening in this game. I'm not sure if that was, if it's glitchy or for some other reason, but I have seen every now and then on some survival videos, I have seen some villagers spawning in jungles. So that could be pretty cool if we could find that. But it doesn't look like there is anything too exciting in this jungle at the moment. It's just looking like a massive, massive freaking jungle. And maybe we should just try and go across it, or maybe try and get to the top of one of these big jungle trees, and that'll give us a decent view of the environment. Yes, that's a good idea. Let's do that, man. Let's climb all the way up to the top of this one, see what we can find, if we can actually get up there. It's like jungle vinage parkour going on over here, and it looks like we're gonna have to dig into this jungle tree, destroying the environmental integrity of the place. That's all right. Actually, maybe we can come up around this side. Let's have a look. Yep, there we go. Beautiful. Let's go all the way up to the top. And that's going to give us a beautiful view of the surroundings. Can we get up here? Nope, but we can clip away this little branch. There we go. Come on. Get your butt onto the freaking tree. Oh, you freaking bastard. All right, we're going to have to do this the hard way, man. Let's do this. And then we can get... Can we get up there? Oh my goodness, are you kidding me? All right, let's get up here. Maybe we can see from up here. This gives... Jungle Temple! Oh my goodness, that's awesome! All right, let's go, my friends. I cannot dilly-dally, man. I want to know what's in there. I don't even know what you get in Jungle Temples, to be honest. I don't think I've ever watched a video of anybody exploring one, so I have no idea what's in store for us. This is awesome! Oh, man! Epic! Okay, hang on, hang on. Right, let me just get a sip of my tea. I need to calm down now. Just hold on. Okay, the last time I went into a temple, it was a disaster. The last time I went into a temple, it was an ocean temple, and I lost all my freaking stuff, okay? So, we're gonna keep it nice and calm. Whew, let's keep it nice and calm. All right, hey guys, this is a jungle temple. Welcome to Jungle Temple Exploration with Rendog. What is going on here, man? Look at this thing, it's freaking awesome. All right, now, let's just be a little bit careful. I am... What was that noise? I heard an arrow. Are there traps in this thing? Is that how this thing works? Hello! Hi there! Hi! Say hello to Rambo. Eat it! Ooh, man, this is so sweet. Let's just get a couple of torches up in here. I'm hearing some freaking arrows going off. Are you guys hearing that? Or is it just me? Okay. Let's get down in here. Look at all of this mossy cobblestone. This is perfect. Oh, hello. What? What? Creeper! And I took an arrow to the butt. Okay, hang on. Hold the phone. Rambo, dude, you need to do the business now. Take this creeper out in one shot, if you please. Oh, that creeper got shot by the arrow? What? Oh, no, no, he's still there. Hi. Hi, creeper. Hi, skeleton. Take it. Okay, there we go. Oh, I see what's going on here. Look at this. There's a freaking... What? There's a dispenser over there. Am I triggering something? I'm very confused. Looks like there is a wire over here. Oh, it's a tripwire. I see the Indiana Jones trickery going on over here. Oh, man. Okay. There is a dispenser shooting arrows at me. Something fierce over here, man. Now, let's disconnect... Oh, this is a red... Hi there! Hi, Skelebutt! Get out of my face, please! Okay, stakeage into the belly. Here we go. Okay, so, this dispenser seems to keep on triggering. I don't know why. I'm going to disconnect its redstone wiring. Hi. Hello there, dispenser. Two more arrows left in you. So we'll disable your ass. There's a chest over here. So sweet. There's another dispenser over here. I see another tripwire thing going on. Let's get rid of that. No arrows in there. Excellent. That's the chest. Are there any traps? Is this a trap chest? I'm going to be super careful, guys. Is this a trap chest? That looks like a normal one, doesn't it? Okay. Now, what is going on with this little thing over here? Is this like some sort of a configuration? Is this like a puzzle we have to figure out? Middle one? That didn't do anything. That did something. I heard a piston triggering. What did that do? Did that open something for us? Oh man, this is so cool! Hang on, so that opened the piston. This one? That opened something else. Did that open up like another doorway or something around here? Let's have a look. I hear the pistons triggering, guys. But I don't know what they're doing. Let's have a look. Did that open anything? No? Okay, so let's try a different configuration. This one. And that one. That definitely made something go... Nothing? What? Okay, I'm confused. I am super confused. What happens if we do this one and these two down? Okay. I am confused. Alright, we've got to try and figure that out, but let's crank open this freaking chest over here. Endergods, please give us something freaking sweet. Kablam! Bones. Great. Thanks. Thanks, Endergods. Freaking buttholes. I've been fiddling with my levers over here, and something has happened. Check this out, guys. There is a little opening over here that's happened. Oh my goodness, there's a creeper down there. There's another chest down there too. Sweet. Okay, so I don't know what I did there, but apparently I figured out the combination to open up this secret little area. And there is a creeper down there, though. Okay, he just bit the dust. Is there another creeper down there, though? I don't know. All right, slowly but surely. Where is Terra when you need him, man? There we go. Let's get down here slowly but surely, see what we can find. Oh my goodness. There is a comparator down here. It looks like it. Any other mobbage? No, doesn't look like it. Excellent. So this is the chest. I suppose the motherlode chest of the temple. Let's crank this sucker open. Blam! 2 gold ingots and some rotten flesh. Really? Are you for real? Is that all we got? A little bit of gunpowder from the creeper's butthole? Is that all you get out of a freaking jungle temple? Really? That is kind of weird. Does this go deeper? Is there like another level to it over here? Oh, come on. There's got to be more to it than that, surely. Let's have a look in here. Nope, this is where we came in. My goodness. Well, I'm very happy that I found this thing, but I gotta say, I'm a little bit disappointed in the loot. This wasn't a very lucrative temple, to say the least, man. There is hardly anything in here. If we break this open, what can we find? Any other chests? Maybe there's another chest hiding under here. No. Okay. I'm a little bit disappointed. I am disappointed. I wanted more out of this temple. That's alright though, we're going to be able to get a ridiculous amount of mossy cobblestone, which is perfect for our needs. Of course, in this series, we do not craft mossy cobblestone. We only use mossy cobblestone that we find in the world. So, that's awesome. That's a huge cache of mossy cobblestone for us over there. I suppose that's a consolation prize, I guess? Cyberdogs, I gotta say, man, I'm mildly salty about this jungle temple. I have waited literally years to discover a jungle temple in this series, and we got absolutely nothing out of it. I don't know how to feel right now. I feel kind of like an explorer that discovered, I don't know, an ancient Egyptian tomb or something, only to discover that inside of the tomb there was absolutely nothing but a couple of, I don't know, old rotting bones of some pharaoh that died a long time ago. No golden rings, no freaking sweet signets, you know, no enchanted ancestral freaking things, you know? Dang it, guys! Seriously, man? Was that it? Okay, well, at least we can chalk it in the to-do list that we have discovered for ourselves a jungle temple. I'm going to leave it there for now. I'm not going to collect the mossy cobblestone now. It's pretty close to our portal that we set up, so we can come back at a later date. For now, I want to carry on exploring. I want to head out and into the unknown and find a village or find something sweet. There is a beautiful little ice-capped mountaintop over there. Let's go check that out. We've entered a little bit of a swampland. Hello there, beautiful freaking... What is this thing? This is a blue orchid. Nice. I think I'll take that along with me. Although we don't have a lot of inventory space at the moment, so we can't be filling our inventory up with too much junk. And I do want to hopefully pick up some new blocks also, get some andesite, some granite, and some diorite if we find it. Luckily, in the John Smith texture pack, these textures are pretty good looking. Diorite, it looks actually pretty good in John Smith, as does granite, so we might find some uses for them. Haven't seen any patches of those blocks just yet, though, so we might have to do a little bit of caving at some point. But first, I want to do a little bit of an exploration of the overworld, see if we can spot anything. Let's climb all the way up to this little peak over here. This is going to give us a good view of our surroundings. Oh man, it feels so good to be exploring again, guys. I have been building and crafting so much in Minecraft, on Hermitcraft, and on this series. It feels good just to get out there again, you know? Just look around. Try and find something sweet. And it looks like there is some sort of a giant plains over there. That's probably our best chance to find a village, right? Let's go over there. Let's go down here and try not to freaking derp too much. All right, there we go. Let's see if we can find for ourselves something sweet in this giant plains. Hopefully, there is a village to discover or something interesting at the very least. When I said giant plains, I might have been exaggerating somewhat. It's actually a very small little plains. Very beautiful, though, I must say. It has a little bay over there that goes into a swampland, and it's surrounded by these beautiful dark oakwood forests over here. Hello there, horsies. Nice to see you. Looking real, real cute. Hey, you know, I really was hoping that we would get a saddle in that jungle. My plan was, when I saw that jungle, to get a saddle, and hopefully we could get a horse, and that would make our exploration a little bit easier. But apparently, we're not going to be getting any saddle action out of that freaking jungle temple. Oh, the salt is real. real, guys. We're going to have to do this adventure on foot for now, I think. See what we can find. This dark oakwood forest seems to spread out way into the distance, which is good. Let's get down into the meat of this dark oakwood forest. Can you actually get villages in dark oakwood forests? I don't think you can. You get mushrooms and stuff like that, and you can find some pretty cool flowers in these dark oakwood forests, but I don't think you can find villages. That would be pretty cool if you could. I've never seen one, though. All right, let's carry on, guys. Go deeper into the unknown. I'm literally just going to travel for a while until I get frustrated. Usually what happens when I go on these adventures, when I'm looking for something like a mesa biome, for example, I travel and I travel and I travel, and like 3 hours passes, and by the end of it, I'm super disappointed, and I just have to go home and, try find a mesa another day because I get super salty. But hopefully that won't happen today. Look at this. Whoa, this is kind of interesting. What is going on here, man? We got this little grove of dark oakwood trees over here. Kind of pretty. And then we have this sort of bank of sand, which looks kind of cool. I'm guessing this could be the beginning of a desert on the other side of this mountain. That could be pretty sweet, man. A desert is a place we could find a village. Let's go check it out, man. Well, there isn't a desert behind this mountain, but there is a beautiful little peninsula here. Isn't this gorgeous? Look at that. Those dark oakwood trees growing on a little island over there. That is really nice, man. I love the look of that. There's a beautiful little cave in here too, which is fantastic. I suppose, though, there's only one more option for us over here, guys. That's to make a boat and go on a little bit of a sail. Let's see if we can travel along the coast. Maybe we will actually discover something if we follow this coastline. So I'm going to make for myself a boat over here. We've come to that stage of the exploration where we make a boat and spend a whole bunch of time looking for something. Oh, man, I do love it, though. I have missed this a lot. Anyway, let's do this thing, guys. I'm going to go traveling all the way along the coastline over here, and let's see if we can find something interesting. I'm going to kick this puppy into fast forward mode, and yeah, we'll see you on the other side of this. Kaplayum! Kaplawi! Man, what a gorgeous journey that was, guys. The moon is rising in full above us right now, looking absolutely amazing. And check it out, I have landed in this beautiful little bay over here. It is so gorgeous here. Look at this mountain. Oh man, this place is so stunning. I would love to make something over here. Look at this, this is perfect for a little civilization here on this land, all the way through this with a river behind it, this mountain behind. Oh, I gotta take the coords of this place, guys. It is too freaking gorgeous for words. Let's try and sleep this night away, though. I've run out of ocean, and it's time to get on foot again, see what we can find. And those skeletons are now gonna burn. Burn, you bastards. I'm not even gonna bother with them. I'm just gonna let them roast to death. That is what they deserve, let's face it. And there's a bunch of zombies up there too. Let's get to the top of this mountain, see what we can see, man. I reckon we could get a sweet view from up there. There's a freaking creeper up there, though. Don't think I didn't see you, you little bastard. I'm gonna take you down. Get wrecked, you freaking... How did you block my arrow? Jeez. Telling you, man, I don't know what has happened to mobs in this game, but they are terrifying these days. Absolutely terrifying. Creepers are like... They're still terrifying, but I think that they are not as terrifying as skeletons. I mean, let's be honest with ourselves here, guys. Skeletons in 1.10 are a disaster piece, man. Anybody get that reference? You get a cookie. Anyway, let's get ourselves up here, guys. See if we can see anything from the top of this giant, beautiful mountaintop. Come on, baby. Give us something awesome to look at. Whole bunch of chickens up here. That's good. But let's have a look. Oh, look at this area. It's so freaking gorgeous, man. Right, keep your eyeballs open for villages or mesas. I'm not seeing anything over here. Let's do a little bit of scouting in this direction. Looks like we're into some sort of an extreme hills, maybe? Or there's a big... Okay, there is a giant plains down here. That is for sure. And I think, if I recall correctly, The very first village that we ever found in this series was in a plains on the second continent. Is that right, all of you older cyber dogs out there? I think that's pretty much right. And we actually murdered the villages. The first villages I ever found, I actually murdered them. I don't know why. Something came over me, man. I just had to take them down to Chinatown. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you just gotta slay them villages, man. Look how beautiful this freaking plains is. Oh, this makes me think of Kingdom Craft so much. This would be the absolute perfect location for a kingdom, wouldn't it? Right in here. Right in here. A gorgeous location for a kingdom. I gotta take a screenshot, man. It is just, it's too beautiful. It's too freaking beautiful, man. You know, over the years that we've been adventuring together, I've taken loads and loads of screenshots of places that I've found. But I gotta say, these two places that I've found today, oh, I don't know. Look at this. Look at this, it's got a natural wall. See, this is the reason that I like it, right? The mountains over here create like a natural wall, a natural barrier for a kingdom in here. Kind of like Mordor, right? Oh, man, inspiration is kicking in, guys. I kind of want to start again and come out here and start season 6 out here or something. Oh man, that could be pretty cool. Who knows, maybe we'll do that. Anyway, let's carry on looking. Instead of thinking about doing crazy stuff, let's carry on our mission here. We have a very clear mission. Look at this! Oh, it's so gorgeous. We have a very clear mission to find a village or find a village or find something interesting or find a mesa. That's the plan. Or, yeah, that's what we're trying to achieve here anyway. So far, all we've seen is some really beautiful stuff, which is cool. Cyber dogs, I just realized something. I done derped something fierce. In fact, I done derped twice. Look at this, I found some dogs. But I left the bones in the freaking jungle temple. Also, I could have collected some dark oakwood saplings because there were dark oakwood saplings right outside the nether portal. There was also a savanna, or I think there was a savanna, so I could have got some acacia trees. We still need to get dark oakwood trees and acacia trees for the season, and I forgot to get them. I am such an idiot, man. And we could have got ourselves a couple of dogs here if I'd kept those freaking bones. Dang it, I am such an idiot. Hello, doggies. Maybe I should just wait around here for nighttime, get some skeletons killed, get some bone action, and maybe we could get some dogs to tag along with us? Yeah, the sun's almost down. But seriously, man, those freaking dark oakwood saplings, though. I'm such an idiot. Wolfpack perimeter has been secured, Captain Rendog. Thank you, Corporal Rendog, or something. Sun is about to go down, guys. Skeletons are about to spawn. I've set up a little encampment over here, I guess, of light so that we can try and capture a couple of dogs. That would be pretty awesome. At least we get something out of this adventure. Missed the freaking saplings, failed in the jungle temple, got nothing out of that freaking jungle temple. Haven't found a mesa, haven't found a village. At least we could get ourselves some dogs, right? Let's get Rambo out and get ready for some slayage. There's a freaking zombie down there. That is not what I need. Get out of here, zombie! You're gonna bite the dust? Hello, dogs. Don't go too far, you hear? Will they follow me if I've got some meat in my inventory? Come with me, dogs. We need to go into the wolf pack perimeter. Oi, doggy! Follow me into the wolf pack perimeter, you butt! Alright, he doesn't want to follow me. That's fine. Ooh, he's attacking something. Is there a skeleton over here? It could be. Alright, I think this is probably the first time that I've ever actively gone hunting for skeletons. It's not usually something I participate in, because, you know, it's terrifying. Skeletons are deadly. But Rambo the Second, baby, this thing kicks some serious butt. Mending flame, power 5, infinity, oh man. We're gonna take these skeletons down to Chinatown, if we can actually find them. Wow, there are an insane amount of dogs out here. There's a skeleton! Hey dude, get wrecked! Oh man, I gotta be careful. If I hit any of these dogs with my arrows, it's gonna be bad times for me, man. I gotta really keep my aim going pretty good here. There are so many dogs in this tundra. It is unbelievable. Uh-oh, leprechaun action. Get out of here, leprechaun. Get out of here. Okay, Enderman. Did I look at that Enderman? No, I don't think I did. All right, we're just gonna ignore that Enderman for now. If we can, try and find ourselves some more skeletons. We've got 3 bones so far. That's not good enough. We're gonna probably need at least 10, I guess, to try and tame a couple of dogs. All we need is 2 dogs, right? Then we can breed them when we get back home. Although I kind of wanna maybe bring 3 just in case we lose one somewhere along the line, because that is probably gonna happen, let's face it. All right. It's a zombie villager. It's a zombie villager. Oh my goodness. I have no idea how far we are from the Molehole 2.0 though. It's probably not a good idea to try and trap him. Also, I didn't bring any name tags with me. So you know what? Get wrecked, zombie villager. I got super excited, but yeah, you're going to have to die. right. Any more bones? Nope. There's another skelebutt though. Stop strafing, dude. Get him, doggy. Get him. Wreck him. Wreck him. Look at this. Chasing that skelebutt down. All right. I'm going to help you there, doggy, if I can. Okay, the two dogs are going to get it. Nice. Get wrecked, skeleton. Wow, that was epic. These are the kind of dogs that I want to have in my pack, right? Let's see if we can tame them. Oi, doggy, what's happening? Oh, no, freaking leprechaun, get out of here. All right, let's try tame this one. Yay, he's mine. Sweet, where did the other one go? Come with me, doggy. Come with me, dude. We need to go get your brother. Hello? Where did he run off to? Oh, here. They're both attacking the skeletons. Oh, I want both of these dogs, actually. Skeleton hunters, man. That's what these bad boys are. Dang it. Failed to get either of them there. Oh, man, that is unfortunate. So we've got one dog. Let's see if we can find a few more skeletons around here and tame these other two skeleton hunters. Oh, man, look at them. They're so beautiful. Actually, let's get a couple of torches around here to indicate where the dogs are. There we go. Where has my other dog gone? He's run off into the wilderness somewhere. All right, let's see if we can find some more skeletons. Come on, you jangly-ass bastards. I've got an arrow with your freaking name on it. I've been hunting skeletons all night, and I've got another 4 bones to feed this little doggy over here. Do you want to be my friend? Come on, you beautiful thing. Boom, yes, we got another pet dog. Okay, so we got 2 of them. That's very, very awesome. The wolf pack has been united, baby. Gonna have to come up with some sweet names for these dogs over here, guys. Oh, man, it's gonna be awesome. You know what I'm gonna do, guys? I'm gonna open up a thread on dogcraft.net for you guys to come up with some sweet names for me, all right? Check the link in the description box below. Dogcraft.net is my official fan site. Don't worry, it is free to join. It is a sweet, sweet forum where cyber dogs from all over the world come together. And I'm going to put a link there. Then you guys can, if you have any sweet names for these dogs, go post it on my forums, okay? And I'm going to choose some sweet names from those lists. All right, let's continue on our adventure. We found 2 dogs in this beautiful tundra over here. That's fantastic. Hopefully, I'll be able to get them home alive. I don't know if it's going to happen, but we're going to give it our best shot. And yeah, I'm going to carry on looking around here. Let's venture forth into this icy freaking plains over here. Looking very, very freezing. But I'm going to venture across this icy plains, see if I can find anything. And next time we see a dark oakwood tree, I'm definitely going to stop because I want myself some freaking dark oakwood saplings. In fact, our mission has changed. We are looking for a mesa biome. We are looking for a village. We are looking for acacia and dark oakwood saplings. All right, that is our current mission. Well, it may not be a village or a mesa biome, Cyberdogs, but check it out. I have stumbled across a beautiful little flower forest, and I'm picking for myself up some allium. I don't think I have allium in Mama Dog's greenhouse, so that's actually really, really awesome. I haven't managed to find anything else since we were last together. I have now traveled to 10,000 by 1,900, and I've chomped through about, I don't know, 20 steaks or so since we were last together, I guess. And all I've managed to find is some freaking allium. So this adventure is getting pretty unfruitful, to be honest with you. It feels like I've been traveling through the same biome over and over again. It feels like I'm in freaking Groundhog Day at the moment. I feel like I might be doing loops or might be doing circles because I don't seem to be making any progress. We got the dogs with us though, so that's fantastic. They've been looking after my butt on this adventure, and hopefully I'll be able to get them home. I've been thinking about it, worrying a little bit about it, especially when we have to cross the ocean to get back, or actually go into the nether to get back. Am I going to have to stick them into a minecart or something? I don't know. I'm going to have to look into that. But yeah, I'm going to have to do a lot more looking around over here, my friends. I'm probably going to spend the next 30 minutes or so just exploring, seeing if I can discover anything awesome for you guys. And hopefully in the next episode, we can pick up for ourselves some dark oakwood saplings, some acacia saplings, and find a freaking village at the very least. Hopefully we'll be able to find a mesa also. That would be absolutely amazing. But I tell you what, guys, I've run out of time today. I hope you have enjoyed this adventure episode. It's been fantastic. I've had a great time out here with my new dogs. And remember, if you want to take part in trying to name those suckers, head over to dogcraft.net. I'll put a link in the description box below for you guys. Anyway, guys, that's going to do it from me for today. It's been Ren Diggity Dog playing some Minecraft Survival. It's been sweet, and we will all see you, or we will see you all, should I say, in the next episode.